That last corner has come, Nicholas Scholl. On towards the start finish line. It was a winning pre-final and a win in the final. It's a back-to-back win, just like the juniors, as Nicholas Scholl comes through. Oh, there's more drama. Josh White
knows this is the last lap. He doesn't want someone throwing a silly move up the inside. Josh White's not going to do anything daft. He's just keeping it calm. He's making sure that he's going to get the maximum points possible, which is that second. That's a fantastic hook. But look at this, as they went through turn 10, that did look like he's closed in massively, but surely he's not going to be close enough to make a move this time. Nicholas Scholl looking one way then the other, and they come on to start finish straight. Josh White trying to make a move, but not quite able to do it. And in fairness, Nicholas Scholl felt that he was going to get that, but my goodness, that was closer than he probably intended.
Yeah, amazing feeling. Can't describe it. It's just unbelievable.
He's going to have to go the outside route because, as predicted, Lambrell's hugging the inside line for the final lap of the race. They're both looking for their first Euro Challenge wins. Trying to go around the outside is Jordan Brown-Nutley. Can't do it. Now he tries the look through the kink. He'll try and line up and move down through the hairpin. Look, Besler's coming back at them as well. Besler not far behind. He's back in the mix. Josh White is in the mix. He's fourth of the lead of the race here. They're absolutely side by side as they come out of the hairpin. But it's still Lambrell with his nose in front. Brown-Nutley in second place. Besler has caught them up. White has caught them up. There's four of them battling over fifth place. Just get back as well with Jonathan Hoggard at the head of the second queue of cards. But who's going to win this one? Down into turn six. Jordan Brown-Nutley can't find a way through. Josh White tries a wide line to try and get past Burke Besler. It's still together. It's still Lars Lambrell that leads the race. Jordan Brown-Nutley running out of time. Burke Besler nibbling away, trying to get second place. Should the door open up? Should an opportunity arrive? But Lars Lambrell, he's just staying on the racing line at the moment, but you can get a toe coming out of the last corner. There could be a chance here for Jordan Brown-Nutley. He gets right onto the rear bumper of the race leader. He's lining up a move here as they accelerate towards the checkered flag. He's going to pull out of the slipstream. Side by side across the line. Jordan Brown-Nutley steals it on the line. Brown-Nutley is the winner here by a fraction. Lambrell celebrating. He hadn't crossed the line, and Brown-Nutley timed that to perfection. And he wins.
That is really competitive, but you've kind of stood out from all of them.
Yeah, it's been a really competitive year. Like, you've just got to try hard, didn't you? Be competitive with him.
Renadan's going up the inside, is he? No, well, Renadan had an almighty run down the straight towards turn five, but he decided not to make the move. And is that his best opportunity gone? He's only going to have just over a lap now to try and make this move. Further back, I think there may have been a change. Well, there hasn't, but as you see the two leaders on screen behind, Jessica Backman, now you can see to the left-hand side, by Backman's name, 0.1. That means she's only one-tenth behind Gary Donnelly, who is ahead of her, so she has a chance of a potential podium here. It would be an almighty lap to do it, but the last lap board's gone out. Let's focus on the two leaders, Adrian Renadan. Is he going to go up the inside? Well, no surprise, Lambrell defends. Renadan goes to the outside, and he's going to try the outside again at turn three. Now they head up towards turn four, and oh, Renadan's got the run! Renadan's got the run there alongside, going down towards turn five, and Renadan up the inside of Lars Lambrell into turn five, and Adrian Renadan takes the lead with half a lap to go. Renadan now has to try and defend to hold on, but Lars Lambrell gets him back. So Lambrell back into the lead. Can Renadan get the switch back? They're going to be side by side. Adrian Renadan backs out. And Lars Lambrell then two corners to hold on. Defends into the left-hand hairpin. Renadan to the outside. We haven't seen anyone take the run at the final corner yet, but will that change? Renadan goes to the outside. They're going to be side by side, but Lars Lambrell is going to take victory. Adrian Renadan finishes second. Third goes to Jordan Brown-Nutley, fourth to Gary Donnelly, Jessica Backman,